And we're live. We are live. We're live. I'm on a Mac. The only difference on the Mac is that when I have FL Studio up, it doesn't show the chat. So what I'm gonna have to do, for now at least, is watch the live stream on my phone and just kind of keep an eye out for the chat that way. So shout out to Viviana, first one up in here. Shout out to you. Let me switch this to live chat mode. And you should be seeing everything clear. I'm looking at myself, looking at myself. Inception, let me change my. Also keep in mind for the live streams, you can change the resolution or whatever to 1080p so that you're not looking at pixelated screens. It's gonna give you higher quality. All right, let me do my shout outs real quick. Sorry, I'm trying to read the chat on my phone. Cynic Beats, Jerome is here. What's up? JW Turbo, produced by Elusive. What's up? SS Fame, Bufo from Sparta, New Jersey is here. He switched up his intro. What's up, man? Rat Boy Ty, what's going on? Azzy Clip, Young Bands is here. What's up, man? I'm on the Mac, so like I have every DAW except Reason and what's the other one? Reason and there's another one. I'm just slipping my mind. Oh, Cubase. So if you want to dig into more DAWs, I'll definitely do that today. Low Cuts is here. Andrew says, yeah, you know what I'm saying. Bento Beats, 8-bit. What's up? Cure Beats, how to make a drill beat. I'll show you some new plugins that are free that will definitely give you a cool sound. GC, what's good? I can't read Russian letters, but shout out to you. Thomas P, what's up? Maurice. Castro, what's up? How do you say that? F's Clow? F's Clow? I don't know how to say that. PHX Clow. Why am I not reading this screen? I'm looking to get a Shure SM7B. Do you recommend it? It's good for like people with lower octave voices. I haven't heard it on a high octave voice. For higher octave voices, I would go with the Neumann brand line. You can start at like, I think, 600 for their mics to get started with those mics. Or Rode NT1A is a good starter mic. But the Shure mic is, it needs a what's called a cloud lifter. So I have one right here. I just don't want to mess up this. I have a couple wires overlapping it, but it's called a cloud lifter. And you need it because it will pull the mic's level up. But this mic is very clean. Like there's a lot of background noise, but it blocks out a lot of the background noise just as is without doing anything to it. So I would definitely recommend it. But I mean, depends on what you're doing though. If you're going to be recording a lot of artists, I would go for a more versatile mic. Even though this is a very Michael Jackson like this mic and everything, but I don't know. I've kind of paired this with the Neumann U87, but that's a very expensive mic. But shout out to everybody. Sorry, I got lost in the translation here. Fix feel. Oh, Phil. Phil Cow Music. What's up? Can't read here. Trey on the beat. Yeah, we're gonna be making beats today. Stary, what's up? Azzy's here from North Africa. There we go. Andrew Serta. Sorry for missing that message in time. Reaper. Yeah, definitely don't have Reaper. Courtney Martiz. What's up? DM makes beats. The Weeville. Oh, you guys just reminded me of something. I have to change. All right. Jivan Music, the Weeville. All right, we're about to start in a second. I just want to show you some new plugins and new approaches to stuff. Tearjerker Matthew. Oh, my thing just refreshed. Dang, where was I at? Well, shout out to everybody who just joined. Oh, Tearjerker, Mason's here, Armani, Kami's here. Use some effects, your voice like reverb. Little Hemisphere, what up? Ethan's here. All right, we're good. Lona Squares here. What's up? Shout out to everybody else. I just don't want to spend a decade reading the chat out loud, at least. All right, but so here's what I'm going to start. It's showing you some free sounds that you can get. Shout out from Thailand. There we go. Brazil. From Haiti. There we go. So, oh, you know what? I got to keep my phone open so I can see the chat. This is a lot of multitasking. Give me a second because the screen doesn't show the chat. So this is going to be an exercise. I got three different screens to look at. Okay, Morocco, there we go. So labs is something that you guys want to look into. At first, I thought labs was like whatever, but then I downloaded all the sounds for labs and it's pretty good. So it's free from Spitfire Audio. If you're ever into like film score stuff, Spitfire has some really nice contact libraries that you can get, and we may use them today. I don't know. But let's open up labs because this is a free plugin. And they have a lot of dope sounds. So I'll go through a couple. But shout out to everybody in here again. I'm trying to like look at my phone to see the chat. I'm trying to. I wish if anybody knows a way to get the chat like on my screen while I'm in FL, but on Mac FL doesn't allow you to resize the menu for whatever reason. I'm not sure why. Probably just because Mac stuff. But they have a really dope piano. So let me mute my mic so you don't hear me slamming on the keys. So this one's called Soft Piano, and again, these sounds are free. Yeah, I like to change the colors in FL. I like their new color picker thing. I like colors. I like looking at cool stuff. I don't like looking at bland gray all the time. So to do that, you just right click on the color selector thing and just change the color. And this will change the color of your notes. So that's that. I'll show you guys that when we get to making a track. So that's the soft piano. Yeah, Neumann is pretty good. Even their lower mics, like the TLM 102. But the starting price is pretty high, so I can understand. The Shure for the price is really good, but remember you're going to need what's called a cloud lifter to pull up the volume of the mic because it could be really low. And the cloud lifter will, like for example, without the cloud lifter, if you buy a Shure SM7B and then you plug it into your preamp and just turn the gain up, you'll hear a lot of noise. But if you run it through a cloud lifter and then the cloud lifter will lift the volume up without the noise. So just if you're going to get a Shure SM7B, make sure you get a cloud lifter. Because your chances are you're not in a professional studio like me. And these sounds are free, so I mean, gotta hop on these. Shout out to Roddy Ricch for making orchestral stuff more popular. So again, I'm gonna turn off my mic so that you don't hear all the bumps and bangs and everything into the mic. And I'll just play some sounds from labs until we find a dope one, and then we'll start from there. Shout out for grabbing Hermes says Straika, Straika, Straika. Yeah, we're gonna figure out. Some people are having issues on their system, so we just have to do some reverse engineering with the troubleshooting. So I'll be doing that with the Hermes customers and everybody who supported Hermes. We're gonna have a private thing where you guys can help me figure out your issues, and we'll figure it out. But yeah, what was I gonna say? The mic is super noisy because I have what's called a noise gate, and if it's triggered, you're gonna hear all the background noise. So the fans are on, you're gonna hear that. And it's just noisy in general. So that's where that noise is from. I like some of their libraries in here. They're actually like film score sounding libraries that they gave away for free, which I'm kind of shocked that they would give away this quality for free. Cynic asks, where should I go to learn piano? First, you just got to learn basic music theory, and then you'll understand that Zeus, that's a mock-up art. So my graphic designer added libraries that aren't out yet. That's going to be a few. It's potentially could be a future library. I might change the names though. So that was a mock-up before we had everything solidified. If you're wondering about the other ones, like Athena was on there and Zeus, those are going to be new libraries. And I'm working on new sounds. But before I get to the new sounds, I want to make sure the plugin's working for everybody. We're going to figure it out. So once we figure that out, we'll be able to move forward with all that. What was I going to say? Oh, you said learn piano. So music theory, once you learn like what a major seventh chord is, it's just a matter of muscle memory at that point. And I've talked to a guy who practiced piano for like over 9 years. He was an expert at piano. And he told me it's muscle memory. It's not like, you know, some magical course or some magical thing. It's just muscle memory. It's literally just sitting down and doing it over and over and over again. That's what's going to make you a better piano player. Now, you have to... Piano players are good because they do stuff. But the question is, the point is, you have to learn how to do that stuff. Meaning, okay, here's what I'm trying to say. I'm not making any sense. So what makes a piano player better than just a, you know, an average producer is that instead of just playing this, these notes, a piano player knows these notes and then he can go up, he or she can go up and down the keyboard. This is probably a bad sound, so let me find a different sound. Pull up a piano. Hold on, where's the piano that I had before? Where'd they put it? You would think it'd be, oh, under piano, not keys. Okay. Okay, so a piano player takes these notes and they animate the notes. So instead of just playing it like this, or like a typical producer would do, just up and down. Yeah, Labs is free. That's probably all we could do as a producer. But with a piano player, they know these notes and they memorize ways of going about playing those notes. So they'll like, you know, they'll think first, fifth, third, seventh. You don't even need to know what that means. And they just have it in their muscle memory. Let me turn off my mic so you can hear all the bumps. And they just memorize different riffs that they learn from different players over time. So a riff is basically a rhythm that they repeat, and they just change out the notes of that rhythm. And that's what a piano player does. They know a lot of rhythms of notes that go in a specific order. Like if Jimi Hendrix went in their song, they'll go, they'll do the same thing. They're just, it's learning a bunch of riffs that you just steal basically and put into your muscle memory. Hopefully I'm making sense. That probably didn't make any sense. So whatever. Yeah, I'm trying to differentiate like a producer from a musician. No, we're not doing free updates for Hermes. Hermes costs way too much to develop for this thing to be free. Costs a lot of money. Whereas Vintage Fire wasn't as cost heavy. So that's why I gave a lot of updates for free. But all the Vintage Fire sounds were imported into Hermes. So if you don't have Hermes, you can update and get more sounds and an easier interface. But let me show you Labs real quick. I gotta keep an eye out for the chat. This is tedious. Also, this keyboard that I'm using is on the actual desk, so it causes a lot of thumps. I might just swap it out for my bigger keyboard, but I'm using the Native Instruments little small keyboard, but it's right next to the mic, so you're gonna hear a lot of thumps. This might get a little tedious. I might use the bigger keyboard next time. I don't think that's true about the beats coming out weaker, the more music theory you know. I think it's actually the opposite. If I compared my older beats to now, knowing music theory, they blow the older beats out of the water by like 1,000%. Because music theory is about knowing what goes with what. It's about harmony. And harmony makes beauty, which makes music sound good. I feel like with Scalar though, you have to know music theory to even navigate that plugin. I don't think it teaches people music theory at all. Where do you get inspiration for writing music? New stuff helps. And having, you have to address your emotional things that are dragging you down before you hop into music. Are you going to make Logic Pro videos? For sure. Heat up Genesis Pro, better than Hermes and cheaper? Well, wait till Hermes is at its full form. Heat up 3 just probably, and again, I don't want to put words into people's, man, but you have to realize a lot of other developers, they just literally take sounds from directly from like a keyboard that already exists. And again, I'm not going to name developers, but they literally just take presets that somebody else made and they just rip the sound as is directly to it. Like if you ever hear a plugin with trumpets in it, you really think they recorded trumpets? No, they took it from probably a Yamaha keyboard or something like that. So a lot of these other plugins are just making you think that they're their sounds, but they're from somewhere else. I don't do that. If anything, we curate and blend the sounds and do really cool structures to the sounds. We don't just rip presets out of a keyboard because it's too easy and simple to do that. That's why we went up to Canada and spent 2 days straight recording sounds from super rare synths that you can't get on the internet. Like they had a real Mellotron, for example. Yeah, we're going to do a private stream with all the Hermes customers. And we'll get all your ideas. Keep in mind, I want you guys to realize it costs a lot of money to develop plugins. It's not cheap. So a lot of the features that we want are just going to be extremely costly. But in labs, there's a library called Charango. And it is a guitar. I didn't even know that was a guitar. Really good for trap melodies. Let's use this. And let's start up our trap melody. I like that C, B, D, E. Let's do that. Now, volume matters with these libraries because they do what's called multi-sampling. Or might do like a different sample every time it hits. I can't really tell. Surprisingly, on the Mac, you would think you need a mouse to run the Mac, but I found that just using the trackpad works a lot quicker than using a mouse. Forgot to add Fruity Soft Clipper on the master. I'm about to add that into my template. Music theory. I have a lot of videos. Just look up my video called Music Theory in, I think, 15 minutes. Just type in Music Theory in 15 minutes or whatever. BusyWorks Beats. It'll pop up. And it's a video explaining everything about music theory in 15 minutes. And it's absolutely free to watch. Let's add... Now, I have all stock plugins, so this is going to be a challenge. I don't even have my drum kits and stuff in here. So we're really going to test FL's... sound selection. I don't even know what these plugins are. I think these are from Logic Pro. What is this? Looks like they don't have an interface. Okay, I guess AU plugins don't have interfaces. I've never used these plugins before. New pitch. Let's see what this is. No idea what this plugin is doing. Oh yeah, it's weird they don't have an interface. That's pretty weird though. So I just pitched it up or down. I don't even remember where we started. I guess that's how the plugin looks, because this looks like a graphic EQ. Cut out the lows a little bit. This is not work effective unless you grab them all. Wait, hold up. Okay, now I want it to double a little bit, so let's add a delay. What happened here? These AU plugins must be tripping out. Set the wet level to half, feedback level down, and pan it out. So it's only one response. I think these are from Logic. You get them on the Mac, so I just installed a bunch of stuff. It's all mostly stock stuff, but it's probably from Logic. Round Trip, I don't even want to mess with those plugins. I have no idea what they do. So now let's add, I didn't realize like how, not limiting, but how much of a box it is to use FL stock stuff. Let's use grow speed, go to presets, momentary, let's go to half speed, pull back the time. Now I want it to flicker a little bit more, so let's add the transient processor from FL, image line of me. Let me move the chat so I can actually see. It's hard to read from all the way over there. Yes, it's possible to learn music theory quickly. The problem with music theory is you're learning it from people who are teaching you like Italian, and you're so confused because you don't speak Italian. And they teach you the old way of learning music theory, which is based on a scale. Let's add this. I forgot how to use this thing. Split frequency. Lower the release. There we go. This is like a mix level. I'm not sure why they call it split balance. I still have a Razer. I'm just trying to check out more Mac stuff because most of the people are on Mac that we haven't talked to yet. People on Logic Pro, we need to convert them over to FL. Where can you get FL? Image-line.com. Let me pull the settings back. Drive this a little bit. All right, so I'm showing you some stock sauce here. Trying to figure out where our transient went. A little finicky here with the transient processor, but oh, you know what, I think it was only listening to the mids. I'm trying to figure out why the signal's so low. Maybe the output gain here, let's turn this up. Now we have an edgy sound. So on the key, the piano roll pitches up and down. You on Ableton? Yeah, which DAW you guys using? Probably mostly FL, but let me know which DAW so I can hop into it. Machine, I forgot about Machine. Turn it back. What it does is it makes the sound more pointy, Robin. It makes the sound more pointy. It's called a transient processor. It focuses on the very beginning of a sound and it just makes it sharper. Oh, you said why the Mac? I got the Mac really to troubleshoot for Hermes, because some people were saying that they use Mac and they did some weird thing and then like the plugin did something. So I got it so that I can follow along with people's steps and what they're doing so that we can figure out how to fix it. Well, oh wait, that might be our solution here. Can we do, can't do split screen. Wait, might be able to split screen. I don't know what I'm doing here. Let me figure this out. This might be our split screen. No, it didn't work. Okay. So for whatever reason, oh, never mind. Let's add some more notes in here so it sounds more musical. So with trap music, you're not always hit shift, left click to drag it over. You're not always just using four notes. Sometimes you use what's called an interval or harmonious notes, which all go together. Then FL, that still works. Cheaper than FL. I don't know, man. There's a certain point where, like, Ableton is priced at its price because it has a lot of good stuff in it. FL is priced at its price because the stock sounds are just a certain way. I think the FL is the best bet. I don't think there's anything cheaper than FL. I wouldn't recommend the mobile FL. I don't think mobile is going to take over. I just don't. For real producers. I know there's some people making crazy jams on mobile, but I feel like you just need a certain screen dimension that needs to be there. There's wet sounds. What are you talking about? Yeah, FL won't split screen. You can click here, but it won't do it. It just won't. Look, watch. I'll show you. Click here, you hold it. You can't do the tile thing with FL. Let's make this a little more modern. Delete doesn't work. Delete. That must be crazy for Mac users. The delete button doesn't work. That's tedious. To get rid of notes, you can't delete them unless I'm tripping out. Well, in that case, let's use the delete tool. That must be really tedious. No way that doesn't delete. Probably something I'm doing. But anyway, let's go to Snap to Grid, make it 1/3 beat, and then let's draw in the melody now. So now it's more of a trap melody. Let's pull this up to 160. I'm gonna take off the drive on the plugin. I was using that so that we could hear it. Hit Option, left click to get it back to normal. F8 for split screen. There's no F8 on a Mac, unless you mean function 8. Nope, doesn't work. I got a Mac so that I could troubleshoot my plugin that I came out with my team, because some people have PCs, some people have Macs. I already had a MacBook before, but it didn't work. I just got back onto the Mac because it helps me troubleshoot. Sublab and Pigments should be a thing for starters. Buy whatever plugins inspire you. I have a video about the best trap plugins. Those are, after buying hundreds of plugins, those are the plugins I recommend. Put whatever you want to split on the second desktop. Scroll up 3 fingers. The second desktop. So like this. Then this. Now we're getting somewhere. But how do you look at both at the same time? Because that kind of defeats the purpose. I want to see the YouTube chat and the... I probably didn't do something, but... I mean, it worked. It just didn't do what I'm trying to do. That's cool. I guess I didn't know you could create multiple desktops. Now I know. All right. Cool. Yeah, I know, it's the noise gate. If I turn up my mic, you're gonna hear, here's what it is, okay. It's called a noise gate. So if you load this up, there's this thing called a noise gate. It blocks out all the background sound. If I turn this off, you're gonna hear all the noise from my room. You hear the fan of the Mac, you hear all this stuff, it's super loud. So I use a noise gate to turn that background sound off. And what the noise gate does is every time I speak, it clicks a little bit and then it lets me talk. I know the click can get a little annoying, but that's just what a noise gate does. Does Hermes really come with all those bundles? If so, I'm going to buy it with... We don't have... if you're talking about the Zeus and all that, that's a mock-up art by my graphic designer. We only have one chord library with 150 sounds in it. 150 plus sounds. It doesn't have like a gazillion sounds in it. The plugin really wasn't even built to have a bunch of sounds in it. It was built to have the sounds that we're actually going to use. It wasn't built to have every single sound in the world. Let me turn this off. So if you're talking about the Zeus one and all that, that was a mock-up graphic. Oh, this thing is super loud. Hold up. All right, let's talk music theory and ease. So here's the benefit of music theory. Why is this thing super loud? So, for example, if you want to do Gunna melodies, you could just type in a G, and now you know exactly where to go from this G. You could play the fifth, the perfect fifth, which would be D in this case. GBD makes the G major chord. Then you can go to E, which makes this an E. It was D, E, G would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It'd be like an added thing, but whatever. Let's slow the BPM down. But now we know this is, sounds like a major because you're going from the tonic to the fifth. It basically gives you options in your brain. That's what music theory does. Arrangement, I think people over-obsess about arrangement. I just think that the energy has to, people have to know that they're moving into the next thing. And that's what a lot of producers overlook is the transition. I think that's the biggest thing, because keep in mind, at the end of the day, the artist is going to rearrange it in Pro Tools anyway. So it doesn't really, don't obsess about that so much. As long as you have two main sections, that's really all you need. But I'll get into it. Now, unless you're a songwriter, that's different. We could talk about arrangement. Let me switch to a guitar. Switch. Again, I'm using all stock sounds, so I gotta figure out what sounds best. I didn't realize using free stuff is almost a headache. This is why you gotta get some paid stuff. So half steps in trap are very ubiquitous, meaning that you're going to create tension. Whenever you go from one note directly to the next, creates tension. How did you cancel mouse click on your videos? Cancel mouse click, you put two fingers on your trackpad and you right click. It's in on PC world, it's right clicking. On Mac, you put the two fingers and you do that. I'm assuming that's what you're talking about. Piano? I'm trying to make an example for a guitar. I think making this into a piano wouldn't sound, we'll see. If we use a grand piano, it could work. So here's a technique. Very simple technique. You don't even need to know really music theory. You just pick the notes you want in threes. So it goes 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Then you change what's called an anchor note. You take this bottom note and you just move it, but you keep all the rest of the notes the same. And that creates, it feels like you're moving through something even though you move one note. Does your music theory class teach how I can create chords to match the melodies? Yes. There's something called reverse engineering a chord. What you can do, let's say in your head you hear dun, dun, dun. So let's type that in. I can literally take these notes and reverse engineer a chord progression with only one note. And without getting into it, we're using what are called chord codes. And what you do is you use chord codes in reverse. So every chord has a specific code. So let's say in my head, it's like a jazzier sound. Then I know that the chord, chances are it's going to be a ninth chord. So that means I need to use the chord code for the ninth chord, which is, and I know I'm speaking music theory needs to you, but I'm just trying to show you how easy it is once you understand it. So let's choose a minor ninth. So in this case, this is our top note. So we're going to work in reverse. So the minor nine chord code is 0, 3, 7, 10, 14. So this is going to be 14 in this case, and we're going to count down the keyboard. So it's 14, 13, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. And this is a lush chord. So let's loop this. And now we know it's either this or the major version of this chord that's in our head. Because when you hear jazzy stuff, chances are it's going to be either major or minor. So what you do is you just take this, the third and the seventh, you pull them up one. And you just ask yourself, is that the chord I hear in my brain? And even if it's not those two chords, it's a variation of those two chords. So it's going to give you the majority of your answers. And my ear thinks that sounds cooler. So that's how you can reverse engineer and harmonize your melody using what are called chord codes. And you could do like a Pharrell thing. I know I'm kind of speeding through all this, but this is what we cover in the course. And we do it step by step, and I make it super easy. I'm just kind of showing you what it looks like and sounds like. I guess the beat's gone a little too fast for you to hear it, but there's a science to it. It's a definite science. Why is my delete button not working though? It's weird. I'm going to look that up, why that doesn't work in FL. All right, let's get back to the scheduled program here. I'm trying to keep an eye out for the chat. Shout out everybody in the chat. Yeah, music theory opens up more moods. And with the modern music right now, you may think it's super simple, but if you really listen to the music, there's a lot of music theory being applied. A lot of passing chords, a lot of chord structures being used now, especially with Gunna stuff and all the like people pushing the genre. We're starting to get into more musicality. So you gotta brush up on musicality if you wanna be able to make these tracks. What's that? Trizza Flock of Flame. We got it working on live. Shout out to Trizza for helping me with the OBS setup. It was definitely a thing with the Mac. Da-da-da. Command X. Oh, Command X. Okay. That's weird. Command X. Oh. Interesting. I don't know. Mac does everything different, so it's going to be a little bit of a brain F. For people hopping over, I'll just give you a little warning. Command X, shout out to you for the Adrian for that shortcut. Let's swap out the sound because this sounds kind of whatever. Now with triplets, you can use a guitar or a piano because when piano players arpeggiate, they're going between three fingers mostly. So this is the little stuff that you learn when you learn how to play piano, just how somebody plays. Now with Scalar 2, you really don't even have to learn piano. I mean, you could take the built-in MIDI. So now I'm going through labs trying to find a dope sound. Sounds very future-esque, this one. Cool Joe Schmo. Yeah, I want to get into more stuff. After this little melody thing, I'm going to get into plugins that you guys have never seen before. But this one's free, that's why I wanted to start out with it, just so you can get your feet wet. Maybe it's possible to pay for a music theory a week later. Music theory a week later? Not sure what you're talking about. I need you see this. Maybe it's possible to pay for a music theory a week later. I wish I knew what you meant. On the keys are funny. I bought that Black Panther movie. It was a really good movie. It's like a good movie after you leave the movie theater. So, I mean, with this plugin, they have a lot of cool stuff. I don't want to bore you guys to death going through all the little nuances. But sounds that just don't sound like Omnisphere. I mean, they have their own life. So I would recommend using this one called Labs. Okay. Let's go to the big boy stuff. Let's open up some new libraries from some film score stuff that I got into. And with these plugins and this sound, I think a lot of you guys would understand music theory a lot more. When you start producing, Castro. When you start producing in film score, you're going to understand why people use the suspended chord, why they use octaves and different things, because you're going to hear the pure mood of the sound. And like, if you're producing a film score piece for a haunted scene, you want more suspended chords because it sounds tense. Whereas trap music, you might not always use those. So, for example, let's load this library up. And I found out with film score, the library really makes a huge difference. I'm using very basic keys and it sounds very good already. And I didn't even do anything. And there's a lot of opportunity to be gotten, be had, whatever the phrase is, with film score. So I don't want you guys to not investigate this world. What happened to... For producers, I feel like I can learn a lot more if somebody helped me on Zoom. We don't do hands-on training. Videos should be good enough. I mean, here, let me give you a little hint. The reason you need hands-on training is because your attention span is very low. You can't watch a video and then immediately apply what they're showing you because you're going to get distracted after you watch the video. Because think about, what does hands-on mean? It just means somebody's telling you to do something and you actually do it. Whereas with video, you feel like since they're not in your room, you don't have to do it. So maybe you just need accountability. I don't think you always have to be in person with people, especially during these times. It's going to be really hard to get anybody to do hands-on anything. So you're going to have to learn on your own. And video is what, that's how, you know, the government trains their employees. It's not always in-person training. Because it works. Okay, anyway, I'm doing a rant. So all we're doing here is changing the anchor note. We're not even changing the top part. And this represents tension in music theory. Whenever you have one note, go to directly to above or below to the next note. Probably diminished, because the chord used to be banned in church. The diminished chord. They call that the demon chord. So I would say by definition, it's the most tense. Now for the longest time, I never used this feature, but in FL, it comes in handy when you're in film score. So if you go down to control, go to channel volume, and I never used to use this because I never understood the purpose. But when you have a multi-sample library that has different velocities, you can actually control the mood of the strings as it's going. And this is key if you're going to make anything film score. So what I'm doing is just telling the keys to play softer or hard. And it just makes a huge, huge, huge difference. You could hit shift left click to make it all linear. You can hit, where is it at here? Oh, never mind. I thought option was going to do something else, but it didn't. But shift, if you want this to be more linear and just kind of fix it back to its linear form, you could do that. I'm not sure a way to delete this without being really complicated about how to do it, going into the events and doing all that. So let's say you wanted it to kind of gradually go up. So again, when you have a sample library that's multi-sampled, it sounds different when you play it softer from when you play it harder. Demons like Bach. Okay, so let's take the same exact thing. I'll show you how to build on top of this, okay? So we're just playing A, E, F, and then we're pulling this over. And now what you can do when you have this kind of volume modulation, you could just do stuff with it. So it's basically going up to what's called a crescendo, meaning all the volume is going up over time. Then it goes down. Velocity is how hard you hit a note. Volume is just how loud a sound is. It's not necessarily how hard you hit a note. So it's a little hard to understand this, because unless you program your own sounds, velocity won't really make a difference. It doesn't always mean if I hit the key harder, it gets louder. It just means a different sample will play per the velocity. So if I hit a note at 30%, it'll play sound A. If I hit it at 60%, it'll play sound B. and those sounds can be completely different. Now let's start building up on this chord progression. And let's give this a dum dum dum, 1 2 3, dum 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 dum. Okay. Again, you're going to learn so much just thinking like a composer versus music theory will make so much more sense. So we want to go 1 2 3. Make sure the time. Let's just copy this over. Now, Trizza was there back in the SoundClick days. Now, Trizza, if you're still here, can you let the people know, you know, the sound selection back in the day, from my experience, was in Nexus. It was called Dance Orchestra. Everybody used the Dance Orchestra expansion in Nexus because it had all these orchestral sounds in it. And this is what made the gave rise to Johnny Giuliano, Cardo Got Wings, Superstar O. They all use these sounds. And that used to be the trap sound. So let's have this volume go up over time so it doesn't sound like it's going fading out. Zombie is in the building. Germany. There we go. Afghan. There we go. Belgium is here. But yeah, shout out to everybody in here. Cool. And now you can start building. So once you have like a basic structure, Sweden's in here, then you can start building on top of this with music theory and ease. Let me turn this up a little bit. So let's add like a diminished chord in here randomly. So usually diminished stuff comes at the end of the third thing. At usually, speaking 8 different languages, it comes at the fourth thing or the third thing. Okay, so in this case, you could pick the third note or you could pick the third run. So in this case, let's pick the third run. Let's make this a diminished structure. So A, so zooming in, diminished chord is 0, 3, 6. So just count, this is your zero note and just count up your keyboard. Sri Lanka's in here, Poland, there we go. Oh, thanks for looking at Hermes. It's at www.hermesplugin.com. So right here, A, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, we're definitely working on more development, so it's a work in progress. And you can spread the chord out so it doesn't sound like you're just playing it all at once. Again, these are little things you learn with film score. So this is technically a chord, and these notes are not a part of this chord, even though they're playing at the same time. And see how it adds that tension that we need. And we could do dun. So I'm literally gonna, here's what I'll do. I'm taking the bottom note here and I'm copying the same exact diminished chord and just pasting it so where it starts at E instead of A. Let's hear what that sounds like. At the end, it gets tense, but it sounds cool. When are the MAC Mixing Academy Complete tutorials coming out? Oh, you mean Mac? I'm slow. Mac tutorials. I'm trying to do one now, but I'm only doing this new stuff just to do different stuff. We've done like 1,000 FL videos. I mean, I got to show the Logic Pro people what we're all about, and then bring them over to FL Gang. Thank you for tuning in. You said you learned a lot. There we go. But I guess what I'm trying to illustrate here and demonstrate is just you can get away with a lot more music theory stuff with film score than you can in trap music because there's a purpose for it. And the purpose is to create tension. So instead of making it extremely tense at the end, let's do like a more lush diminished chord. So the secret behind this is just counting threes. So just count up three or down three. So it's 1, 2, 3. And the notes will repeat after a while. 1, 2, 3. Because every octave has 12 notes in it. 1, 2, 3. So they will repeat 1, 2, 3. And then back to A. So this is a little esoteric secret. I learned a lot just from all over the place. Let's pull this down so it goes dun, dun. So we want, what is this? E to be the top note, hit shift down until that top note is E. We could finish it off with the proper chord. Now, I found out with music theory and film score, you don't, okay, I'm trying to like make this make sense to the beginner. When, like, for example, if you grab a stamp and you pick a chord that you like a minor ninth chord, or whatever chord type you like, and you drop it in, with film score, they don't, it's called voicing. They don't voice the chords the same way. They don't just play all the notes in a row, especially when it comes to the strings, because it just sounds too dense in frequency. So you have to spread them across the frequency ranges. This is why you have the violas playing certain notes and the flutes doing certain stuff. And all together it plays a chord, but it's spread out. Learn new things? Oh yeah, for sure. You have to. I'm reading like constantly in the other room. Oh, Mixing Academy Complete? Well, the thing was, I thought I was going to have a commercial studio, but due to Corona, I don't know if I'm going to go through with that deal. So what I'm going to have to do is show you how to mix in over headphones. I was going to show you how to mix in an environment that's actually pristine, but win some, you lose some. Plus, the majority of people don't have a room where they're paying $1,200 a month to mix. So, I mean, I guess we got to show you how to mix with what you have. And then we get a... Not sure why this... Oh, duh. I just think when you have a film score mindset, you'll understand more about evolution of the sound, arrangement, where stuff needs to change up, where the BPM needs to kick in. Because you're making the music the drum. You're not using drums to do a lot of stuff. And this is just the string ensemble. This isn't even with brass and all that. You gotta be where the people are if you want. Well, what do you mean by context? Who are you trying to attract to you? Nick's Beats. Who are you trying to attract to you? Artists? Are you trying to attract the managers, the lawyers? Well, who are you trying to attract to you? Manu Plummer from India. There you go. That's awesome, man. Glad you could apply it. So that's the benefit of a film score. Let's clone this. And let's try to make like a little thing. So this also teaches you layering, because let's switch this to a different thing. Let's do clear. This is similar to EDM when they layer a bunch of stuff. And hopefully exposing you to these techniques will help you make better trap. Simply layering just makes everything sound full. With genre film? Really, I'm just showing y'all how to get into a different mindset with music. This isn't for anything in particular. If anything, I want to make my own trailer music for Hermes. That'd be dope. So something just epic. And I haven't even gotten into all the little velocity differences, transitions, all the little nuanced stuff. Oh, you know what? This doesn't have the same channel volume. Let's see if we can do this. Can't hear this choir because it's called a sustained choir, so let's put it on something shorter. Still hard to hear. I guess the choir notes are going too fast. Let's try marcato. Very soft. Again, you probably wouldn't make the choir go that fast. They don't sing that fast. So if anything, maybe some brass. Let's swap that out for brass just to give it a fair comparison. Mic keeps blipping, so I'm gonna turn it off for a second. At this point, I'm just separating the octaves. I want to see if the brass gets harsher. Just that's kind of weak in my opinion. So again, I'm not trying to act like I'm a film score pro right now. Just listening to the sounds. Is this something else? But yeah, once you have the proper library, everything is pretty easy. I mean, I know some film score people who are getting away with just pressing one key on Omnisphere. So you guys can do this too. And you could start out with labs. They have a lot of free sounds. Because this is going to expand your clientele to beyond just music producers, to beyond just artists. Now you're going to be able to get into those film opportunities. And not only that, you can take the film opportunity and say, hey, artist, I have this film opportunity. And what artist wouldn't jump at a film opportunity? So now you have even more leverage simply because you changed the way you were doing stuff. So this does a lot more. Like, for example, somebody asked me to score some commercial material down in Miami, and I just did it. And then once you do that, you can take that, tell your artist or whatever that you're trying to work with, that you could get them placed into that movie, and now they're more willing to work. Right, what am I doing here? I need a vocal. Now, FL, I wish it was a lot more simpler with their key switches, but when I use key switches, it tends to mess up in FL. I think it's something that FL has to fix. And I'm trying to figure out why this isn't playing sound. Hold up. There we go. So what we're going to do with this vocal is just take all the top notes that we played in the first one. So we're just using the same exact notes, okay? So here, let's do some shortcuts. Let's hit Option L, which is going to make the notes longer, or Alt L, and then hit Alt G. Wait. I didn't do anything. You know, these shortcuts may be different on Mac. But if you have any notes that are overlapping, they will group them. So let's do something like this. I guess that shortcut doesn't do the same thing on Mac. It's whack. Yeah, we got a lot to get through. All right, so let me make this a little bit shorter. So let's hit Control. Highlight these notes, hit Control X on Mac, and just use the vocal as a leading tone, which is going to guide our ear through the chord progression. I'm going to get rid of these low notes. Hold on, y'all. Let me level this stuff out. And just take all the top notes and just make them longer. The FL has the best piano roll, hands down. It's called a noise gate. It is a little annoying on this computer. I'm not sure why it's clicking so much, but it's super loud in this room. Like, if I take it off, you hear all the noise in the background. So, I mean, that's not really ideal. Plus, for me, I don't want to be doing something and it gets picked up by the mic. I have a, you know, stuff that goes on in the background I don't want put in the mic, so I have to use what's called a noise gate. But for whatever reason, this one clicks, and I think it's because the fans are so loud. All right, so let me just finish this little vocal melody and we'll move to the next thing. Here, I'll turn my mic down for a sec. Again, you can use the channel volume to make it more film-esque. So, you know, like that. Just turn the volume up over time. And have it follow the same volume movements as your other stuff. Wait, I missed a question. You said when you export it, it still doesn't sound loud enough. How loud should your beats be? You can't prop the way you measure loudness is not like a dB level, but they should be hitting somewhere around -3 or -0. Oh, thanks, Bose. Appreciate you. Let's move into something new, because I feel like if you don't have these libraries, you're not gonna be able to follow along anyway. So. But I'll be definitely doing more. More film score inspired stuff, just so you guys can get more opportunities and see how big of a field music really is. Like, for example, Isotope isn't just huge because they work with producers. They're huge because they work in the music and the movie industry. They do a lot of work with people who edit the vocals and stuff on movies. And that's why they're such a huge company. It's bigger than just music. But I want to introduce you to other industries as well. All right, so I want to do something in Logic Pro. You want to switch DAWs to Ableton. What you want to do? I have Luna, which is a Universal Audio DAW, if you want to check that out. What else do I have on here? I don't have too many plugins. I can show you some contact libraries. That might be it. Yo, brother, yesterday I watched your first stream. Friend circles at the end really made me think of that. Oh yeah, that ending was pretty epic. Thanks for tuning in yesterday. How long does it take to master FL Studio? You got to learn. The problem with FL Studio is you're going to learn from a lot of videos about habits that are bad. And it's going to take you a long time to unlearn those bad habits. So once you learn from somebody who knows what the heck they're doing, like myself, go to busyworksbeats.com/FL Studio. There's a free series on how to learn FL Studio. You're going to learn what not to do. And that's going to save you a ton of time learning the program. Because this program comes down to 5 buttons right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You shouldn't have to click any other button except the play button and the song button and the metronome button. Or like a couple of these. But it comes down to 5 buttons. And what you're going to learn on other channels is how to use crappy stock sounds and all this stuff. It's going to be a waste of time. Intuit. What do you mean? Logic Pro? Let's check out Logic. Logic has some really good stock sounds as compared to FL Studio. So let's load up Logic. I have to keep FL open just so my mic is here. And we're going to figure out. All right, that's the plug-in scan anyway. So I'll, if you have any questions or anything, I can take those now while we're waiting for this thing to load up. What are you guys doing on a Saturday? You can do Gelatry. Oh, wow. I forgot about those guys. The selection-based folks, selection-sounding folks. Is selection still a thing? I think I've seen them, but it's not like the huge wave that they were. I know a lot of those kids went on tour and stuff, though. FL, I mean, FL is probably the quickest DAW to learn because I've opened up these other DAWs and there's so many, like in Cubase, for example, I went to draw a pattern or like a clip, whatever you want to call it, a MIDI clip, and I couldn't figure it out for the life of me. Like certain DAWs are just not intuitive. They just, it's almost like a programmer who doesn't make music made the program because it's not even intuitive to a person who makes music. Or just anybody in general. Like the fact that you have to click anything else to make a pattern in the Cubase is just confusing. Yeah, Ableton Biz are definitely going to be here. Watching this on a Saturday. Hopefully you watch and play video games or something at the same time. What do you think about Studio One? I like it for the Melodyne integration. I like it for some of its piano roll options. The sounds are good in Studio One, but Studio One's mixing plugins are really good. But when it comes down to making a beat, it just can get a little bit difficult because of the workflow. This is taking a while to load. Didn't realize. Probably because I have so many plugins. One thing about FL, it doesn't take forever to load in the beginning because it keeps a memory of where the plugins are or something. So it doesn't have to scan every single time you open up. Well, every live stream isn't for everybody. So it's one thing we have to learn in music business is when you have a big audience, everybody doesn't like the same thing. Like that's why some videos have 2,000 views, some videos have 4,000, some have 50,000, because they're all catering to different people. There's no one streamlined thing that everyone's gonna watch. Can you teach us how to make hard style? I would have to really study that. I don't listen to hard style at all. Oh yeah. Anxiety, for me, walking helps a lot. It levels out my hormonal system. Like, how many steps did I do today? I did 6,000 steps already, and I only walk my dog once. So, it calms you down. When you walk a lot, it just calms you down. Ableton is pretty scary for the first time. Yeah, I couldn't figure out how to make a clip in Ableton to save my life. I was at the music store. And I went to like create a clip on Ableton. What's up, Gypsy? I went to make a clip on Ableton and I did not know how to do it. And I just got up and walked away. But FL, even if you just mistakenly click in FL Studio, you're gonna make a pattern. And you go, oh, I just made a thing. But in other DAWs, that's not how it works. And it's super confusing for no reason. You count your steps. Yeah, I have an app on my phone called Health. I think it's called the Health app on the iPhone, and it keeps track of how many steps you do. He's in the other room. He needs a haircut. Asher's not here right now, if you're talking about that one, the little dog. But King's in the other room, but he needs a major, major, major haircut. And I tried to give him one, and he freaked out. So every groomer's closed right now.
King.
Okay. He slipped on the floor.
I'm sorry. You all right? You okay? Are you all right? Yeah.
So this is, I don't even know if y'all can see him. He might be a little small. Kingy. But he's super over it. He doesn't like being on TV a lot. He's super over it. But he definitely needs a haircut. Definitely needs a haircut. He's like, get out of my face. The best guitar plugins, Ample Sound has some pretty good ones, but I think Ample Sound got rid of one of the plugins because I went to look for it on the website and it wasn't there. All right, so we got Logic Pro open. Let me make a track for my mic and then we should be able to hop over here. Check, check. Ooh, audio feedback. Using the built-in speakers. Crap. I don't know. What is this about to do? It's about to blow up. Input, we need to put this on UA. All right, checkity check, check, check. Should work. Output, we need to put this on this thing. Oh, wait, input. There we go. Check, check, check. Wait. Check, 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 check. I can't tell if the. Oh, wait. Check, 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 check. I'll pan one to the left so I know. Oh, yeah, there we go. All right, so we got the mic open in Logic. Now we can hop over to Logic real quick. Close out FL. All right, now we're in Logic. Boom, can you hear me? You should be able to hear me. Don't feed that thing after midnight. What thing, what are you talking about? You're talking about the dog? I had the same year with Reassuring. All right, you're talking about the camera. King's super, he has to learn how to be here again. He wasn't here for a long time because of the quarantine stuff. So let's see what Logic Pro has to offer. I think by default, though, the sounds are just way better than FL. Just off. Check, check, check. How does this work? Wait, if I'm not on the track, then you can't hear me? Check, check, check. Oh, there we go. All right, so for the longest time I can never figure out what the heck this screen meant. It is a little confusing if you don't know how to use Logic. We're just going through new plugins and new DAWs just to explore a little bit, just to show you there's more options out there. So the starting sound is pretty dope. Let me turn off my mic so you don't hear all the background stuff. So the sounds off the rip are way, way better. And again, for the longest time, I did not understand Logic's interface at all. Like, I did not know what it was. So long story short, on the left side, it's just showing you what the sound is and where to pick from the sounds. And in the middle, they're showing you like a little quick edit button for that specific sound. So if you just wanted to load up an e-piano and throw an EQ on it real quick or throw some stuff on it real quick, it loads up like this little mini preview of the bigger mixer. So that's what it does here. Let me see. Wait, Logic Pro wants to install your download. Da, da, da. Everything on a Mac needs like permission. So, so they're like, hey, do you want to open up your MacBook? He's like, yes. Hey, do you clicked on FL Studio. Are you sure you want to open it up? It's like, yes. They ask permission for everything. Anyway, on the left side, you can pick the sounds. This is like similar to a browser in FL Studio where the sounds are, except it only loads their sounds, from what I understand. I don't know how to get to plugins yet. Still haven't figured that out. But I'm assuming since I didn't install any plugins, they're not going to show up. So I'm assuming this is just their sounds. So if you wanted to swap out their stock sounds, you would go to guitar and pick your favorite sound. Let's go to acoustic guitar. Mm-hmm. preamp do you use? I use a, it's called a Cloud Lifter for the Shure SM7B. You need it because it cleans up the signal and it makes the mic actually work properly, like at a nice volume. And then, what was the other question? What audio interface? I use the Universal Audio Apollo. I wouldn't start there. I mean, just get any one you can. Scarlett has pretty cheap ones. So you can see the sounds are superior, in my opinion, to the stock sounds in FL. And I think Logic Pro costs $299 or $199. I can't remember the price. Yeah, a lot of stuff is expensive, but I need it because I have a lot of inputs from all my keyboards and stuff. But anyway, what else about Logic is cooler? But when it comes to the piano roll, FL kills everything. It also shows you the chord up top. This is a really dope. I wish other DAWs just stole this feature. Like, if you play a really cool chord and you don't know what it's called, you now have the chord mapped out up top. I think that's the dopest feature. One of the dopest features. So let's see if I can hack my way through a pop track using Logic Pro. Again, I have no downloaded sounds, only stock stuff. So we'll see what they have. We're gonna work through this, make a pop track. So I wanna start with like a bell or a guitar. Probably a bell. Let's start with some bell stuff. Darn, my mic turns off while it records. Check, check. We're making a pop track. Darn, I can't talk while this records. Check, 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 check. Well, now it's not doing it. Check, check, check. Anyway, yeah, we're making a pop track. So I'm just looking through the stock sounds, trying to figure out something. We'll figure out something. But a lot of people who make pop use Logic. So now I'm just cooking up a track using Logic. This little keyboard is a little tedious to use too. But way better stock sounds than any other DAW I've heard. Let's see where we could take this. So that was a very basic playthrough chord. Let's double click on here. I'm assuming that opens up the editor. Now you can see how it gets messy pretty quick. Cool Joe Schmo, shout out to you, man. So you could turn off the browser and the information tabs. I don't know all the shortcuts, so when I don't know something, I hit Control A and I go to edit, and it usually has what you need. Either edit or, so we need it to quantize. So I'm gonna look for the word quantize somewhere. Quantize, where you at? Edit, edit, edit. Maybe move. Join notes, no. Select. It's in a sub menu, which is never good. Okay, quantize is not listed in the main things, which is very odd. So it must be down here somewhere. They'll give me the shortcut if you know. I'm trying to find it. Scale quantize, we don't want that. Q usually stands for quantize. And you could just hit Q and it quantizes to the nearest, whatever this is set to. Now I'm wondering why it's not up top in the edit menu. Let's go back. Now, with pop music, we gotta be a little cheesy here. So that's why I'm doing this. Let's move the notes. How do we go down an octave? Let's transpose negative 12 semitones or option up. Wait, option shift down. Option shift down. So what we need to do now is set a loop section. So let's click on that loop button, and usually a loop thing will pop up, and I'm just gonna select 8 bars. Now we can go back to the sound selector tool, go to our Dreamy Bells and swap it out for different sounds. Some will sound better than others. What I'm doing right now is trying to figure out the relationship here. Let me see if we can clone instruments or duplicate instruments. Let's see if there's a duplicate function. Copy. Track. We should be under track. No clone options, a little odd. Little things you miss from FL, but hopefully we'll figure out a shortcut in the future because I can't find it. So I'm trying to make a pop track. So it's gonna sound really, so what I'm gonna do is get into the music theory of it all. So right now we started off with a C chord and went into the kind of C major scale. Now from this point, when you add more instruments, you can use octaves or the same note up or down. And you could use what's called a perfect fifth. So in this case, the perfect fifth of C is going to be G. Let's find that sound again. Let's do mallets. Or where were we at? I forgot. Percussion. Where'd it go? Percussion, homemade xylophone. Percussion. Where'd it go? It just disappeared. Hold up. It was under synthesizer, that's why. Okay, synthesizer, percussion. And this one. Okay, so now I'm just gonna go back and record the root note, the perfect fifth, and the octave. So it's C, G, C. This only turns my mic on when it runs to record. Okay, whatever. Anyway, I'm just gonna go back and play. I forgot the rhythm I had, so let me practice a little bit. Yeah, so on Logic, they put a new step sequencer in here. I was just gonna get to that once we got to the drums. It is actually pretty good. I think Reason even started doing that. It took them a while to realize the reason why everyone liked FL Studio is because this channel rack is incredible. What's up, Carlos? So let's quantize these notes. Again, I don't know the what did we just do here? I think we highlighted all the notes. I just wanna highlight this section. So let's hit Control A, and I don't know the shortcut for quantize yet, so let's just hit the quantize button. Now it looks like boom, ta-dum, dum. Let's quantize to the 16th note. Maybe we'll have more. Now again, you can see how the piano roll is not gonna match FL. Nothing matches FL's piano roll. You know, there's a lot of zooming in stuff. That's why they added that step sequencer. Alt Q or Q. Really? Let me try this. Oh, good looks. So you can hit Q to quantize. Good looks on that. Now that we have the cheesy, corny part out the way, let's add some modern stuff to it, but you need that kind of cheesy foundation for it to sound pop. Now let's load up some more synthesizers, but more saw based synthesizers so that we can make it more modern. So let's do EDM again. We're under synthesizer preset. Let's go to we want EDM chord, but I don't want it to have a chord built in. Oops, let's hit Control Z. Let's make a new track and go to synthesizer, EDM chord, or we might just go to lead. I'm not sure where they categorize what I'm looking for. But if this is playing chords per one note, I don't want it. Yeah, it probably will play one chord. Let's load up a lead instead. See what they got. Darn, the leads only let you play one note at a time. Let's try, where would this be? I need like a pad, but not a pad. Won't play on your keyboard? What do you mean it won't play? Did you download the libraries for labs? Because you have to download the libraries separate. You need this thing called Spitfire Audio app, and then it helps you manage all your downloads. But you have to go to their page to click get, and then you should be able to add sounds from there. It is a little confusing. I remember when I first got labs, I was like, what am I even doing? But you have to go to their website and then add the sounds. It's like a get button, and then it will add it to your Spitfire Audio app, and then you can download it from there. Push the step sequencer, it's like FL. Yeah. We'll do that when we get to the drums. If you want to plug in drums or something in there called Alter Beat, dope. So much to discover. I'm looking for something that has a... Let's see if we can load up like a synthesizer. Like, how do we load up their synths? Like the E whatever synth or the whatever. It's not really clear. So you can play it but not on the keyboard. So in that case, you have to go to your MIDI settings in FL Studio. It's called Options. Go to your MIDI settings and then go to that little bottom chunk of the screen and click on your MIDI controller and click Enable. Sounds like your MIDI controller is not plugged up. That's my last guess. If the sounds work, then it's the MIDI controller. So you have to make sure it's plugged in, all the USB stuff's plugged in, powered on. Go to your options in FL Studio, MIDI settings, or MIDI options, and then go to the bottom chunk of the screen that says MIDI input, and change that to the name of your controller. And then there's a little button that says enable right underneath. That should fix it. Thank you. So now we have that cool like Drake underwater sound. So let's hit Q. Wait, let's hit Control A, Q to quantize. And we need to cut out the low end on this sound. It has way too much low end. So let's pull up the channel strip for this specific thing. Let's just pull down the values for the low cut. Forgot my mic doesn't work when it's recording. So now that we have the basic outline with that cheesiness underneath that gives it a pop sound, now you can go in and add the soul stuff on top to elaborate. So now I can go back and swap out the sound. I'll probably keep it bell based. Now we need some drums. Now we can add more to the music, but I thought we were going to go for a more EDM sound, but we turned out not doing that. So I don't know what I just clicked. I think I double clicked. If you right click and let's go to new, I want to say drummer track, pulls up the step sequencer. No, that's not it. Delete. So what I'm trying to do right now is find our step sequencer. Where is it at? Where would it be? Forget where it was before. I know it wasn't hard to find before. I'm probably just overlooking it. Well, duh, I am overlooking it. Let's try track. Chat, help me out. For those Logic users out there, how do we get to the step sequencer? It's not very evident. I do remember loading up some type of drums. I just don't remember where they came from. Spins 808. I've never imported samples into Logic yet, so I have no idea. My first time on live on Logic. And I don't have any samples downloaded. So let's figure out how to find the sequencer because I have no idea. I think it's a piano roll option and you can switch between the two, I think. Or that might be Studio One. Here it is right here. It says step sequencer. Okay, so piano roll, step sequencer is on top. So if you load up some drums under drummer, whatever this is, and this looks like a loop player. This might be something else. How do we get drums though without this thing? We shall figure it out. Let's open this up. Let's go to our menu browser. Let's go to drum kit. This is where I was, drum kit, and we're gonna go through the drum kits. Here we go. Let's get rid of this loop. That is a dope loop though. Logic people use Logic. It basically does everything for you. All right, so under Blue Ridge, let's go to step sequencer mode, and here's where you can, it's basically like FL Studio, because I heard Logic got an upgrade. I think this was part of the update. The only thing is the stock sounds aren't, you know, like hip-hop, so we gotta kind of hack our way through this right now. Let's just do 4 to the floor, boom, ch, boom, ch. Actually, 4 to the floor would be a kick every single beat, but. Now I'm going to go back to the sound selection and just swap out each kit until we get to the sound that we want. I just found out the Control D looks like it duplicates the track. Did that by accident, okay. What's up, Kambazi? Ultra Beat. Where's Ultra Beat though? I don't know how to find plugins or anything. I guess you can click this little plus button. That does something too. It's not very evident wherever it is. Okay, let me see if I can Control C, Control V. That didn't do what I thought it was gonna do. Let's put the playhead in position. Hit Control V. Okay. Now I'm going to swap out the drums. His Logic Pro X. The loops made it, it did make it look like GarageBand. Just going through their stock sounds, I want to see if we can get close to a pop sound with stock sounds. Now Studio One's default drums are really good. I'd say Logic Pro is the best starter instruments. Ableton has the best, like overall, the way they handle audio, it's really good. FL has the best piano roll. And easy to use. So everything has their own advantage. This one probably has the most modern sound to it. Now, of course, it needs mixing, but. So, I mean, for stock sound, again, the instruments are very, 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 very good. For the Studio One, sounds though, they have better drums, they're more hip-hop focused. And let's mix this and just kind of, I don't want to overly produce this because we didn't really make a crazy track. Let's make these drums a lot bigger. So what I do with the compressor is I push it really hard so I can hear the actual volume dipping down. Shout out to Grime for grabbing Hermes. Appreciate you. And what we're going to do with the drums here is push the compressor until we hear it and then mess with the attack until you can hear the transient come through. And then you pull back your ratio settings. So what I'm doing is training my ear to know when the attack knob is coming in. So another trick is turn up your input gain so it pushes the compressor a little bit more. And you can level out your output gain, makeup gain. Yeah, we definitely need more modern like pop drums. Again, I'm using stocks. Oh, you know what? I just realized they have an electronic drum kit. Didn't even see that. Shout out to you saying that, because if you didn't say something, I would have just kept it on regular. This is a little bit better. Let's give this like a modern mix. This isn't FL, yeah, it's Logic Pro. I'm just using different DAWs, different plugins, just to open up our mind a little bit, see how. So now I'm just mixing the drums with the compressor. And it looks like it swapped out the plugins. So let's add a compressor to this drum kit. We probably don't need one because they're synthetic sounds, so you don't need to really compress them that much. But same trick. Turn the ratio up pretty high, like 4:1. Turn your threshold down to about -20 dB, just so you can hear the compressor and then mess with your attack time. And then once you hear the compressor, then you can pull back your ratio back to 1:1, or I mean 2:1 or whatever. Yeah, I don't even have Hermes downloaded on this plug on this computer yet. I just realized they have a distortion mode. It says soft distortion, so it adds a little crunch to the sound. Dip, busy dip, that's funny. To this pop song. We probably could make it modern if I knew how to do halftime in here. I'm not sure how to do halftime in here. You said, hey Busy, I bought Hermes last night and it failed while downloading. I'm not getting no support from your team. How to re-download the plugin? There's an email that we send you when you order Hermes, and you could just go back to that same email and click the download button. Could be your internet provider, because I know they're having a lot of power outages mysteriously during these times. But just try to download one thing at a time and clear your cache in your browser just to make sure that there's no data left over in it, and just hit restart again. But there's no download limiter. Just check your email for the, and then there's a link to the page where you can download all the stuff, if that's what you're wondering about. So check your spam folder, check your promotions tab. Maybe you lost that email or never knew you had it. And it will have the links to that page so that you don't lose it. Let's put this on hard distortion. That soft distortion sounds so much better. I literally forgot about the feedback at 6. Yeah, I'll be doing it though. I just forgot. Yep. Let's see if we can individually turn the snare up. So Logic Pro overall, my impressions, this is my first time using it. I used to use it to record my machine stuff into it. But as a user, once you kind of know your way around, it's pretty good for a DAW, just off of the stock sounds. We're gonna crank up the snare volume. And now you can hear the drum smack way harder. So for those who tell you compression doesn't work, I'm not sure they know what they're doing. You know, I forgot hi-hats. Now it's making me want to finish the track at an 808 and all this type of stuff. Might as well. How do we put the playhead over here? Control V. Need some hi-hats. So let's hit Control D to duplicate. And let's double click in here. I don't know how to add a track. How do we do it last time? Create MIDI region. All right. I want this to be more than... Wait a minute. Could you speak on what compression is, or in your mind, the easiest way to think of it? I really went over the technique a second ago. What I do for drums, specifically for drums, is let's go back to the compressor here. So what I'm going to do is turn the ratio up really high. And then what I do is I turn the attack really low. And then the threshold should be somewhere around negative 20, somewhere around there. And I just let the sound go through the compressor and I listen to it work. So a key indicator is this little thing moving. So it's telling you you're taking out 10 dB of volume. It's overly compressing the sound. It's making it sound squashed. So what we're trying to do is make it blend into where we can't even hear it, but it's there. So what I'm doing is slowly lifting up the attack time over time, and you'll hear it go from a really squashed sound to a controlled sound. See how you can hear the beginning of the kicks again? So I'll do it again just so you can listen for it. Listen to in the beginning at zero attack, you can't hear the kicks at all. They're turned down in volume. But as you pull up your attack, it opens it up so that the kick hits and then the compressor starts working. That's a quick way to do it for drums. Now, vocals are a little bit different. I'm going to turn down these claps a little bit, a little too loud. So I was gonna do something with the claps, like spread them out to a different pan position, but Hotline Miami, cousin. Let's add some hi-hats to make this start making it sound modern here. So again, I don't know how to create what I wanna create, but let's create a pattern region, okay? And let's start with these hi-hats, closed hi-hats. So it looks like the step sequencer here might be the wrong move because I want to do hi-hat rolls. Now, let me see if this works like FL, where we can send it to a MIDI or piano roll. It looks like you can't go back and forth, though. That's whack. Because let's say you wanted to do a hi-hat roll. How would you do that on a step sequencer? It looks like you could probably change the measure. That's, nah, man. This is where they lost me. Because in FL, you can make it go da, 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 and then in the piano roll, you can make it go faster. I would also like to nudge this sound a little to the right. Oh, note repeat. Here we go. So it's under note repeat, and let's figure it out. All right, I just left clicked it. That's a little too fast. I'm just like clicking around and it does its own number. I'm not sure how it determines the number. Just depends on, I guess, how high up you click. Oh, duh, you could drag it. There we go. But note repeat sounds kind of like robotic. Let's add another. We don't want this to happen every single bar, so let's, I don't know how to pull this back. Drag in, drag up. Oh yeah, I found it. Time shift means like just nudging the notes a little to the right so that they're not perfectly on the grid. I'm sure it's somewhere in here, but again, I'm not like, we need to have people who make beats just talk to the designers and be like, look, this is what we actually do to make beats. I don't know how to, we'll just let it duplicate. I don't want to sit here and have to learn. It might take too much time. But what I want to do is not have it repeat every single time. Maybe I could do a control D, but even then. Okay, so now I'm gonna mix the main sounds. I guess it's a habit. When I start something, I gotta finish. Let's save this project, call it live stream pop. Okay. Oh. Why did this thing stop playing? What happened? Something happened. I don't know what happened. Okay, now the song doesn't want to play. Anybody know what happened here? Can anyone tell me what happened? What happened? No, for real, this thing won't play. The freak. Whatever, it just broke. Something happened. I didn't do anything, it just broke. So since it broke, you gotta hit rewind to hear it. What in the world is happening here? Whatever, y'all, it just broke. Let's go to, what could have possibly happened? I can't even think of what could have happened. Audio drive crash, really? You wouldn't hear me though. If that were the case, let's check our preferences again. Make sure this is all straight. Core, da, 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 da. I don't know what happened, so whatever. Logic is, I guess my synopsis so far is it has really, 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 really good stock sounds. Drums are pretty cool too, because this is a dope kit. But the thing is, MacBooks cost a grip, so that's the problem. What else? FL is good at close and reopen it? It's gonna take a while, huh? Is this our first? That was weird. Okay. Okay, our first Logic Pro X weird crash. There we go, live. So the drum kits are pretty good. I'll give them an A on that as far as the 808 kit and the other drum kits are good. As far as the default stock sounds like synthesizers, guitars, all that, really good sounds in Logic Pro. The mixer plugins are really good. Usability is kind of simple, but kind of not at the same time. So it's somewhere in the middle. I'll give it like a 5 or a 6. And what else? What else? What else? I can't think of anything else about Logic. So, oh, let me mix the keys and then we'll wrap this up. I have no idea how to read this thing. This is probably the hardest thing to read. I have to like squint to see what this thing does. Oh, the automation, I didn't even get into that. Ooh. But for the price, this is probably the best DAW for the price as far as overall everything, less the piano roll. FL just wins as far as the piano roll and all its shortcuts and stuff. But as far as the sounds and everything else, this is definitely killing everything. As far as what I've seen so far. Oh, the Island Mallet Sharp Main. So let me kind of mix it, give it a different flavor. Again, I'm trying to figure out what this screen is. I have no clue. I just figure out how to switch out the plugins. You go to input, change out the plugin. Just figure that out. Does the lab work with FL Studio? The lab. Is it my Arturia lab or the lab? I'm trying to figure out what you mean. Any help on mastering? Yeah, we'll do a little mastering here, but the track doesn't have vocals, so I can't fully show everything about the vocal process on mastering, but... Oh, labs. Does the labs work with FL? Yeah, it works. My only thing is, you said when you hit a key on your keyboard, it doesn't do anything. So my only guess could be your MIDI controller is not linking up with FLWrite, or the actual libraries that go inside of Lab aren't there. So you need the Spitfire Audio app, and then go to their website and click Git, and it'll ask you to log in and all this. Then you can add the libraries from there. I think the Spitfire Audio, I forget how it works, but just that's the process. But if you're not hearing sound, and when you hit a key, my guess is the MIDI controller. You said it's busy going live at 6. Yeah, you got a video on techniques for vocal top line melodies. Vocals for me are very like impromptu. There's no like real structure. I mean, understanding music theory could help. I get this bug on FL where I get to change settings. Works until a tab into the piano fix. That's a long question. I get this bug on FL where if I change settings in any VST and try to play a note, nothing works until I tab into the piano roll and fix it. Never heard of that one before. You might want to go to the settings and look at like the bridged button. I forget what it's called, but go to like settings, VST wrapper settings, and click those buttons there. Usually those buttons help. Are you adding transient energy with the compressor? The goal is to tame it, to make it feel really linear. So to have a really quick attack on that cavern sound thing, that Drake sound. Would you be interested in some content for the new FL Studio scripting? Scripting? You're talking about the MIDI scripting? I don't know how to do that at all. It's something that average people aren't going to use. It's for developers, I think. Thank you. So right now I'm just taking off all these plugins so I could add a limiter on the drums just to make sure. I think the compressor has a limiter actually. I don't think I turned it on though. Actually, we're not going to turn it on because I'm not sure how that affects the master track. I wonder what the equivalent of a Fruity Soft Clipper is in here. I think it's the soft distortion, but that seems different because it's distortion. So I'm just trying to mix this to finish it out. Can you explain the gain staging a bit? We'll have to do a video dedicated to only that. Because it's... Right now, it's too much to explain. Just turn up... Here's a quick thing. Just turn up your headphones. Just turn up your headphones. And then start doing it from there. Your ear will start to pull stuff down naturally. So just turn up your headphones. It's really that simple. It sounds like... I'm just brushing off the question, but in reality, just turn up your headphones. You got all the ideas, the phaser on the drums, the reverb on the clap. Oh, I definitely forgot an 808 drum, but it is what it is. I don't have time to edit. But what you would do if you wanted to send it to the reverb, this sends to bus 3, and then you would go to your reverb. Looks like they have a pre-built in reverb stuff. And then bus 3 goes to the large studio. You just turn up the amount. So you said the clap. I don't have the clap solo, but it looks like you can separate. Okay, here's where it gets complicated. Let's find the clap. It sounds like a clap, but it's actually a snare. You would send this to bus 3. This is so convoluted. Bus 3, here we go. Then turn this up. Whoops, what did I just press? I don't know what I just pressed. That opened it up a little bit. So I'll work on the stereo out and then we'll wrap this out. Why no FL? Because I just want to try something different. We were in FL earlier, but kind of got bland. It's the weirdest thing when you cut out the lows, it makes the low end heavier. MIDI scripting, I was confused about how to aim, what is aimed at. Yeah, it's for developers. I have custom scripted my own MIDI in FL because the keyboard I bought was made for Ableton. It's just so unnecessarily complicated that I don't think a lot of people are gonna use that feature. As far as users, I mean. Thank you. thought we were only working on the mids, but now I'm on side only, and I don't know what it looks like. The same stuff. So I thought I was doing mid side EQ. I guess not. Whatever. But not gonna obsess about that. Yeah, I didn't really go all the way in with this track. A vocal could have been cool. An 808 would have been cooler. I don't know what these plugins are, so give me a second. Hold up. Check, check, check. I don't know what this plugin does, forget it. Let's just add a compressor, wrap it out, man. So here's the technique. So now that you can hear all the instruments affected by the compressor, I'm turning the compressor up really high, like the ratio really high, the threshold starting at negative 20. It already put it there by default. It's just like a really good place to start, negative 20 dB, and then slowly bring up your attack, and you'll hear the compressor, you'll hear the transients. It might be easier to work with the release first and then the attack. That was a quick little mixing thing. We could have went harder with the mixing, but just wanted to see if we could twist the sound a little bit. Anyway, Logic Pro, overall, my impression of it is highly recommended, 7 to 8, somewhere around that range. And we'll wrap it up because I need time for myself before we go live again for the song feedback. And then I'll be back on live at 6. But I appreciate everybody for hopping in. That was how long have we been streaming here? Let's see. We've been streaming for 2 hours and 22 minutes. I thought I fixed the resolution. Now it says the stream's current bit rate is lower than recommended. Whatever. All right. Feedback is at 6. Song feedback. Yeah. Go to facebook.com/groups/busyworksbeats. Join there for more info. It's busyworksbeats.com. Oh, my shortcut didn't work. Let's do this again.